I will show you how to code movement script and animation. Add a script to the player object by selecting the player object, and then let's add a component, this type movement controller. Select new script and create and add. Let's just move this to another folder just to be more organized. And let's drag it there. Double click the script to open our editor. What you see here is the default code for new Unity scripts. Update is called once per frame. If you have a game that runs 60 frames per second, this update will be called 60 times every second. Here is also what we called a fix update. This is almost the same as update, except this is called in a fixed interval. Also, right after this code, physics calculations are done. So in short, it's better to use fix update when working with physics object. First, we want to handle the movement of the player. The function we are going to use is input get axis raw horizontal. If the player presses the right and left arrow on the keyboard, this will store the value in horizontal movement. This value is -1 if the left button is pressed and +1 if the right button is pressed. Now we want to store it in a vector2. So let's just create a vector2. A vector2 is just a storage for x and y axis. For the x axis, we want the parameter to be horizontal movement. And for the y axis, we just want it to be 0. Let's move this input get axis raw because input should be called in update. So in fix update, we're going to use the movement to move the player. We need a reference to the player, so we'll use rigidbody2D. Let's make the serialized field so that we can access it from the editor. And then we set the rigidbody's position. So movement multiplied by speed multiplied by time fixed at the time. Let's just break this down. Movement is equivalent to -1 or 1 depending on the buttons pressed. And then speed is equal to 5. We have a constant here. Then time fixed at the time is 0.02, which can actually be found in the editor. Now we're done with the code. Let's just set the rigid body. Let's check the player. Scroll down and we have the movement here, but we haven't set the rigid body. So let's just drag the rigid body object into the field. And then our code should be running now. Moving right, moving left. Okay, so it works. But then, it looks weird without the animation, so we're going to do the animations next. Let's just save the position first so that the player stays on the ground. Okay, so now the player is on the ground. Go to sprites and then character. We need to import the assets from itch.io. Once you've extracted the characters, let's just drag it into the characters folder. Click the first object, hold shift, click the last object. And then let's set the pixel per unit to 32. Set the filter mode to bilinear. Let's apply the changes. And for the sprite sheets, we have to set them to multiple and slice them. Let's click the arrows so that we'll see each individual sprite. Select all and then drag them to player. This will create an animation which we will save in an animation folder. Let's call this idle right. You'll notice that an animator is added here. First, let's just play. Our player is already doing the idle animation, but then we want the player to run when we're moving right and left. So to do that, let's open the animator. Double click the controller in the animator and this will open the animator window. Let's create the other animations before we proceed. go back to the animator window. Let's delete the other animation since we don't want to use that there. Instead, what we want to do is create another state from a new blend tree. We'll also rename this blend tree to run. Select the idle write state and make a transition to run. And then let's also right click run and make a transition to idle write. After the idle write animation, it will go to run animation. Then after the run animation, it will go back to idle write. Let's just play that to see it in action. So the progress bar means the progress of the animation. So we want to add a condition here. We want to animate the run only when the character is moving. So we do that by detecting the square magnitude. Square magnitude is just a formula to detect movement. So let's make sure parameters is pressed here and then click this add button or plus button. And then let's set this to float, which is just a decimal. Let's change the value to square magnitude. Make this capitalize square magnitude. And then select the arrow and add the condition here. Make sure the arrow you're selecting is idle right to run. In the idle right to run, select square magnitude. So the condition is if square magnitude is greater than zero, meaning there is a movement. And then let's select the next arrow. And what we want to say is square movement is less than zero. Oh, let's just change the values to 0.1 just so you know that it is actually moving. And for this one, the player has started decelerating. Now with the transitions done, let's create our blend tree. Double click on the blend tree and then we'll see here a blend tree which we can drag. The values are 0 to 1. Let's first add a motion. Right click, add motion. Let's add another motion since we are using run left and run right. Add motion. So we'll see here that we have a blend type of 1D. So 1D just means that we're depending on one parameter. So let's just set the animation to run left and run right. So when you drag the bar to the right side, the character is facing right, and when you drag it to the left side, it's facing left. This is dependent on the threshold. When it is around 0, it will be using the left animation. When it's around 1, it should be using the right animation. We want the left side set to be negative 1, so let's disable the automate threshold and set this to negative 1. Also, we should add a new parameter, let's call it horizontal movement, and let's use it for the parameter in the blend type. Let's just fix the typo. So what this does is, depending on the horizontal movement, the character will be facing left or right. Now we're done with the animator part, let's go to the script and edit the code. We want to reference our animator, so create an animator and let's make this serialized field so we can edit it in the inspector. In the update, we want to update the animation, so let's create a handle animation code here. Let's also just clean this up a bit. Let's just create a function void handle input and move this here. So what we did is just move input code into a different function. So for the handle animation, we want to set the parameter values by doing set float. So instead of float, we're gonna set square magnitude to movement square magnitude. And then animator, we also want to set the horizontal movement. So here in the update, we'll be calling the handle animation, which will in turn set the float for the animator. Let's just set the animator in the editor, select player, scroll down, you'll see that the animator is here. And let's just drag it to the animator. Play this and our player should animate. Idle animation, moving right. Okay, moving right. Oh no, moving left. Gone. I think he fell. So let's move right. Then let's move left. You see that there is a delay before actually changing animations. This is because of the has exit time. So let's just select the transition and let's disable the has exit time, and also we can set the transition duration to 0. Let's do this for the other arrow and disable has exit time and drag this. Then transition duration will be set to 0. Let's try this again, replaying. It's reacting much faster now. So left. Right. Okay, so I don't know if you noticed, but there's a bug. Let's move right, stop. Let's move left, stop. Okay. So when you move left, the idle animation is facing right. This is because we added a state that defaults right. So what we are going to do is change this to a blend tree also. So let's just disable this and let's create a blend tree first. Let's right click the entry and then set state machine default state. Connect here. Let's redo the transition. We're done, and let's just check this. Okay, this looks correct. So let's go into the blend tree. Let's select the blend tree and add two motions. Since we will be using this for idle left and idle right. Let's disable the automate threshold and set -1 for idle left. We'll be using a new variable. Set this to float and let's call this last direction. So in the parameter, let's set this to last direction. Let's just check the animation moving left and let's play this. That's a idle animation and then right idle. Okay, that's correct. We still have to add something in the code. Let's just copy this and set the last direction to last direction. We don't have a last direction yet, so we'll create one. Last direction is just the last movement before it becomes 0. So this will also be a vector 2, add last direction. We'll set the last direction in handle input. Equals movement. Then we'll also add a condition. If horizontal movement is equal to 0 and movement x is not equal to 0. We are not moving horizontally. And what the movement dot x is not equal to 0 means is we were moving because we haven't set the movement here. So we'll set the last movement to last direction. And then after that, in the handle animation, it will be called. Let's test this. Let's hit play. Moving right, top, moving left, top. Okay, so we've set the left movement animation and it looks like it's working correctly.
A few moments later.
It's working correctly, but there is another bug. Let's just stop this. Notice that the character is facing right. Play. Then he went left. So why is that? Let's go check the blend tree. Then drag this right. Then drag this left. It appears to be working, so what was the problem? So let's just set this to 0 and you'll notice that the preview is still facing left. A hack would be to change this to 1.01 and it will be facing right. But then we don't want to do that. Let's just set this in the code. But first we want the last direction to be default facing right. So let's just one set this to 1. And then in the code, what we're going to do is we don't want to set the last direction if the last direction that x is equal to 0. So if we run this, and now he's facing right. Let's test it again. Moving right, stop. Moving left, stop. And we're done. The player can move left and right. For our next video, I'll explain the jump movement and the animation.